Okay, I just want to make a video highlighting another video that I just found, and it's goes into the history of the world's fairs and how there was these old buildings that were like built from antiquity that were all over Europe and different places of the world where they held these world fairs back like the time where the telephone wasn't invented yet to the early like 1920s. Like 1927 is when the company that demolished these buildings from antiquity went bankrupt. This person lays out that there was an artificial plan back then to demolish these old buildings from the past to make a reset of the population's like knowledge. They wanted to erase any sort of historical buildings by setting up these fairs and putting up small temporary buildings, but then when the exhibit was over, they destroyed not just the temporary buildings, but the main building that the fair was based around. And he goes into if you have a worldwide communication network before the time of the telephone, and you know what goes on mentally between the masses, you know, how different ideas, different opposing ideas arise in certain places of the world, and if you have a worldwide communication system, you can expose that and tilt the masses into a direction that you desire. And it was all done by communication back then. Like, this is a great, it's long and there's a bunch of parts in it, but this is a great documentary.
The process of dialectics, i.e. the study of opposites and their resolution, is a fundamental aspect of mass psychology. Usually, on emotionally loaded issues, the masses split into two opposite poles, thus creating a field of tension. To control people, it is necessary to control both poles of this field. By controlling both poles, thesis and antithesis, the desired synthesis outcome can be predicted.
Yeah, so that's how the
assassination was a sort of alchemical prop to transform humanity.
So there were
by Richard. This allowed
the rest of us.
Here they are. See, look, here's these buildings.
Were built with a technological capability, actually built from scratch.
They say that there's these palaces and these historical buildings where
of the industrial age not only hid once widespread technological knowledge from us.
Yeah, see, that's not a temporary building right there. That's not temporary. They built these world fairs around these magnificent buildings from historical origins, and after the World Fair was over, they destroyed them. And there's nothing left but open parks, and there's just these like postcards of what used to be there. There's only like a few buildings still standing, and that's because the general public went into an uproar about the demolishing of these old buildings. And whatever they didn't get permission to demolish, supposedly accidental fires burned a lot of them down. Like, one report says that there was fireworks that went awry that burnt this gigantic palace down in like Germany or something. So, like, look, that's not temporary right there. That is a permanent structure. Permanent structure. And they destroyed these buildings at the World Fairs.
World, the many Greco-Roman cities would have been difficult to explain because, in contrast to Europe, the Americans do not have an official Greco-Roman history. The more carefully one investigates, the more difficult it becomes to find plausible explanations for the construction and destruction of these extraordinary and huge exhibition areas.
Yeah, there's
and
such
buildings.
A...
and even the world's largest organs.
Yeah.
No expenses were spared in the making of these massive structures.
Destroyed.
Made of plaster and linen or hemp.
Supposedly all temporary, and there's nothing left but tiny little bridges like this and like little stools. What do they just show? A stool, a little Kubota. All that remains of these magnificent buildings that were destroyed systematically
funding.
With world fairs.
Which it's like, despite the 2.5 visitors in the tent.
Change. Standard. Wood, platinum, only meant to last for the duration of the exhibition.
This is,
It is said that even as it was being built, it was inspired by Roman overgrown ruins. In keeping with the mood of
the Palace of Fine Arts is, what is it, in San Francisco? That was one of the structures that was saved. The Palace of Fine Arts, and it's one of the... That's it right there. There's evidence that shows that it was a permanent structure, and it was spared.
Isn't the palace still holding up remarkably well in this photo from 1919, a full 4 years after the expo ended? Where are the weather-related signs of decay? There are further contradictions. Allegedly, all buildings were only cheaply and quickly raised from the plaster, but the Bill Graham Civic Auditorium still stands today.
Yeah,
unlike
see, that's not a temporary structure.
Never fundamentally...
These are magnificent buildings, and it sounds like it was a major tragedy, a loss of precious history. These structures that they show in this documentary are gone. There's just these pictures of them, because they held world fairs around them, and then they systematically demolished them afterward. That is a heartbreaking story. It's hard to not believe. I mean, it seems like that could have been very easily possible back in those times, because there was very primitive communication technology. And if you control business back then, you control the process of things. And it's kind of ironic how the company that was demolishing the buildings after the exhibit was over made the revenue of the exhibit go into negative. The events, the world fairs, started to lose money. They lost like $2 million, then they lost like $8 million, and then when the last demolished place was over and there was no more left, the company went bankrupt in 1927. So that company, the one that went bankrupt, would be the only one with records of any sort of evidence that these buildings were even there, but and actually real. It's a very convincing documentary. Because they show some really incredible architecture in these photographs, and and some of them were burnt down when the public was in uproar about the demolishment of these buildings, and those ones were burnt down. Some of them still remain, very few, but if you look up World's Fairs between like 1840 and 1927. You'll see photographs of these magnificent buildings that no longer exist. And they look like they were very important to our cultural history. Yep, see, so this place was completely burnt and destroyed by the fireworks, I think, he says.
How steel and glass can burn so fiercely? It is important to know that in glass production, the raw materials are heated to about 1,600 to 1,800 degrees Celsius.
Yeah, there's a building made of glass and steel that supposedly burned down to the ground. Oh, man. Okay, so this is called...
But finished glass.
Stolen History, The Mystery of the World's Fairs. And it is a very convincing documentary about structures that were systematically demolished during the quote-unquote World's Fairs by the controlling business elite, and they wanted to do a reset, I guess, back then, from the old kind of way of thinking to our more modern way of thinking, you know, where we're all thrown in preschool and school and brought up, you know, wanting the white picket fence and the American dream and all that. And they did that reset during that time. That was during the Great Depression. So they, right after all those World Fairs in 1927, right at the end of the Great Depression, they did a reset back then. And they started to educate the youth into a different form of way of thinking that led into, you know, the people of the 60s and 70s and so on and so forth. It's all this. History is very interesting when documentaries like this come out. I highly recommend it.